Seems like I've been here before. This is very familiar. So this is, I've been here with the girls.
There's another bird.
Bet she could sit down and pet that one on the head.
Baby. Looks like every little bundle of fur here has a mother. We leave the dock and then repeat it when we go to do our experiment. She brought out this big chest and I thought, is this a great country or what? I thought it was full of beer and it's not. It's full of all things we need to do to test stuff.
Head slap and next row. Head slap, leap. We're now working on 1442.
Yeah.
Head slap. Leap, 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 leap.
Jesus.
Boy, they're acting really spunky today.
What'd you say, there was a cartwheel leap?
Thank you.
they run, they take off. It looks like they're running downhill. Like his mother saying goodbye to her chicks. Strange sight. Now littering a field full of these infants. A couple of leftover juveniles. Golf course. And there's the green down here. But there's a couple problems. When you shoot a golf ball, and it'll probably hit an albatross. And so it's not compatible with the mission statement, which is preserve the wildlife. Another problem is anytime these albatross see something white and round, they sit on it. And you really can't find your ball anyway. So this is part of the elimination. They're going to eliminate this. This do what they call fairy terns. And they lay their eggs right on the trees. One of the reasons they want to get rid of these big trees, they'll lay their eggs up there in the wind. The chicks will blow off. They don't want them that high, as this is an alien plant. They call them aliens. They're just not afraid of people at all.
They don't regurgitate. See the chick under the bush right there?
Oh my goodness, but he's got eyes.
Yeah. Another little chick right there.
You're a big one.
I don't know if you can see that red tail on there or not. So, look.
Somewhere. So he would go in that, come through the tunnel, he'd come up here, it's a very lonely coast. One Marine, the 50 caliber machine gun, and your job was to stay in there until the Japanese got you out. And you can see there's another one over there. You can imagine with bushes around it or sand or camouflage, you wouldn't see these things until you're right on top of them. And now if everyone...
Perching? The dolphin monitoring stations. Which we man until sunset and record every time we see one of them do something cute. That's our dolphin crew. This is our land station. That used to be it until all the old people couldn't get up and down there. You know, whereas most beaches are kind of rocks along the beach, this is actually broken up cement with rebar. So it's in World War II remnant. The seaplane tie down. Broken up runway. With rebar. Rick's an ex-engineer. Neat guy. And our studies for the morning.
Up there.
I switched the dolphin.
I
one again?
Just overpowering, isn't it? Overwhelming. Just can't see it.
Other than her baby. They just lay them anywhere. Hang on, baby. One of them, they feel like doing that, so. Mother feeding. Baby asking for it. Mother opens her mouth and regurgitates right into his beak. Oh, that's enough. All right, one more. Oh, come on, Mom. just a little bit more. I'm trying to cough it up. There it is. Bruce says 14 years of postgraduate education and being. Years of schooling and she ends up sifting seal shit. It's a scat. This is to find out what they eat.
I had a rice
so these people are on the monk seal program.
Go get it. Kill them. This is a heck of a monk seal.
There's some ribs.
We have one more bag to go.
Oh, good.
I see some bones. You see, I have bones. Some bones and stinky bones.
Dolphins are hungry.
You can drop by along here. And these are what the seal people are doing.
These are what the true scientists are doing.
These people paid to come out here and do this.
They're dead this morning. Mother didn't come back until too late.
Of work to be done. One of the things that we're trying to do is get rid of the harmful aliens. That's one of the first projects. He has a, what's called a spreader, and he puts it in there and he opens it up and he takes the band and he gives it to Nanette, our biologist. And she has a log. And that's how we keep all the records. That's how we find out mortality rates. That's how we know things like, you know, only 26% of the white terns make it as opposed to 70% of the albatross chicks, things like that. And so that's all part of the research, because as you know, many of you have had questions and we don't know all the answers. And we may never know all the answers to a lot of the questions. So we're just trying to figure it out. But we know that there's still just a few running around and saying now that we're trying to get rid of.
If you were to come in my office and say that you wanted to see a book on alien plants, I would look at that. Alien plants made it to Midian. It's the 5 W's.
Not losing it. Breathing. Just sitting there guarding it. Oh, what a sad thing. There's Lou and her group getting ready to take an afternoon hike down the beach. But she says the Bataan Death March is about to start again. They take them to the farthest part of the island, dump them off, and have them walk all the way back, picking up seal shit along the way, and then they process it. Tropic Island. We're going to visit the Doctor Cemetery, which is the only people who are buried on the island of Midway. The attrition rate of these little birds is about 50%. Right on those are.
You know, the wind has been closing right off the bridge.
These are the black-footed boobies. When the black one comes up to a white one or vice versa, they won't have anything to do with each other. It's like a caste system. Mother and baby. Who?
Cute, he's so cute. He's a cute guy.
One of the abandoned runways.
This is a successful family.